You guys already know I am the biggest helmet laying simp. Yo, what up guys? It's Jin here with a new video. Today marks 1 year on YouTube. Reflecting back, I've come a long way in both content and production value, but I'm still not where I want to be. Moving forward, expect higher quality videos and more diverse content. For today's video, I will be showcasing a few of the pickups I've accumulated over the past couple weeks, along with my Portland purchases. Before we get started, I'm going to have to ask you all to drop a like and comment because the engagement lately has been egregious and I don't want this to carry on any longer. I realize that the Too Cool Act isn't going to help this channel grow or help me reach my goals. And if bigger YouTubers can ask for likes, comments, and subscriptions, then I can set my pride aside and do so as well. So please take a second and like, comment, and subscribe if you're new. And you can follow me on my Instagram at JinQLu. Because some of the pickups that I have are not just clothing, I figure I would do a monthly favorites type of video similar to what Owen Hyatt, Sanjeev, and Avery Ginsberg have done in the past. We're gonna start off with clothing pickups, some vintage, move our way to the essentials, some books, a movie recommendation, and some songs I've been listening to recently. All right, let's get started. My first item are these Stussy over-dyed gray sweatpants. They're made out of 100% cotton. They have cuffs at the leg openings and drawstrings at the waist. These are kind of hard to find. It took me a while to find them because they sell out. They retail at $100 to $110, which is a great price point. Just a very comfortable pair of gray sweatpants. A great alternative to the John sweatpants. I've owned the John sweatpants in the past. I'm not a fan of the quality. I'll drop a screenshot of this conversation that I had with whoever runs the Jound account, the Jound IG account. I received my sweatpants, there were loose threads, the sweatpants started peeling after a couple wears, just not the greatest quality. I don't see that happening with these. I will have to put some wear into it before we know for sure, but I can already tell these are a higher quality pair of sweatpants and at a cheaper price point. So these gray Stussy sweatpants. The next item I have is also from Stussy. These are the beach brushed pants in the black colorway. They have a drawstring elasticated waist. These are also 100% cotton. They have a loose fitting, almost baggy fit. These I purchased from Notre. They were on sale. I think they retail at like $95. I got them for $65. So just a great pant for summer, all black, easy to wear. They look great with Vans. The next two items are both from Machus. They are both t-shirts. This black or charcoal color is the basalt, and then this green one is the fair green. So this exact t-shirt is called the Modern Tee by Machus. If you don't know what Machus is, it is a family-owned boutique based in Portland. Their logo is these six embroidered lines, and that is because their opening date was November 11th, 2011. So that's just the date, 11-11-11. At first, I wasn't a big fan of the logo, but then when I found out that there was meaning attached to it, it made more sense and I don't mind the logo as much. So getting into these two t-shirts, I'm not gonna pretend like I know every single detail. I will be reading it off this phone. So there's mild distressing on collar and hems, slightly oversized boxy fit, drop shoulder, silicone wash for improved feel, potassium fade wash process, tight collar, 100% cotton, tonal bar logo embroidery. That's the six lines that I mentioned. These are 5 ounce in weight each. Interior branding Machus, and these were made in Los Angeles. So at $55 a pop, these are a very light and comfortable t-shirt. I am absolutely in love with this green one. I've been wearing it nonstop. It's slowly but surely become one of my favorite everyday t-shirts. The basalt colorway is similar but different to this bare knuckles one that I'm wearing. For half the price, you cannot go wrong with this one. I do like the distressings. The Machus t-shirt is slightly longer. I got a size medium in both, but yeah, you just can't go wrong with a $55 t-shirt that's going to last a lifetime. So moving into the vintage pickups, this first item is a Northwestern Champion reverse weave from the 1990s. I purchased it from Kissing Booth in Portland. This has distressings at the sleeves, sleeve openings, distressing at the collar or neck, some fading on the logo, and blue paint distressing here on the chest. Has a great fit, very cozy. I have ties with Northwestern, so seeing this at store, I knew I had to pick it up. This next item I also purchased from Kissing Booth. This is an original 1940s World War II wet weather anorak. It features a lace-up collar and adjustable drawstring waist. There are buttons for tightening at the sleeves. And on the hood, there's actually an extra flap here. Just, again, for function. You guys already know I am the biggest helmet laying simp. Helmet drew inspiration from this jacket. I'll pop up two photos. I haven't seen one that I like in particular yet, but since I saw an original, I decided I'd pick this one up in the meantime. So yeah, form follows function. This jacket is very sick. There is unique fading on it, pockets at the chest on both sides with button closure. Just a great jacket that I can also use when it is raining, purely for function. The fit is great, exactly how I would want a anorak or parka to fit me. This next section of the video are the essentials. So starting off, I have here a Stussy cup. This is the three people stacking mug. I like the graphic on the mug, and I'm a big coffee drinker, so my favorite cup, or actually most used cup, is my green MoMA cup I bought a few years ago when I was in New York. It has a ding on it, so I figured it's time to buy a new mug. I also purchased this from No Tray. I think it retails at $25. I was able to get it for $20. This is ceramic, made in Japan, so the quality is definitely there. Next, I have here a blank white tee. I purchased this from Muji. You would have seen it in my last vlog. The t-shirts sell in a pack of two for $15, crazy steal. This, if you can see, is lighter than your Uniqlo Supima tee, which is great for the summertime. I will say you should size up if you plan on buying it. This is a size large, but I think it fits more like a medium. So a white tee, very, very essential. And I can see these gradually replacing my Uniqlo Supima tees. Next up, I have a pair of Calvin Klein boxer briefs. So I bought these before I left for Portland. They came in like yesterday. These come in a pack of seven on Amazon. These are very, very essential, very comfortable, 100% cotton. I swear by these, so. Great boxer briefs. I had to throw it into the pickups video. My next pickup here is the Salomon hydration vest. This is the Skin 12 set. Here's that 12 right there. I'm trying to do more outdoor running, and this incentivizes and enhances the experience. I don't enjoy running, but in order to attain the physique that I want, I will have to do more running. I don't like carrying the phone on this deltoid area, or just on the arm in general. I think the best way would be getting one of these. There are cheaper Salomon, and Patagonia also does it, the hydration vests. This is super comfortable. You can carry water, and this will in turn push me to run further without making all of these excuses and stuff. I will say, if you plan on buying one of these, you should purchase it from REI. They have this co-op program. It's $20 lifetime membership, and you can return the item up to a year. So with wear and tear, I hear that these will fall apart. I'll just go and return and swap it out or try a different brand, whatever the case. These don't really go on sale, so that's why, again, I suggest if you do buy one of these, just get it from REI. Lastly, there is a whistle on here, emergency whistle. Moving on to the last two essential items, I picked these both up in Portland. This first item is the roll-on deodorant from Lilabo. This is the first time I've purchased a Lilabo product. When I sampled it, I wasn't too sold, but I figured I'd give it a try because it is $32, much cheaper than the Aesop deodorant. This deodorant has grown on me. I almost prefer it over the Aesop deodorant. So this scent is made with bergamot. lavender, violet, and tonka bean. I didn't know that we had a Lilabo in Chicago, and because Chicago is a bigger city, it actually has a city exclusive scent, so I can't wait to go in to the store here in Chicago and try out that city exclusive scent. The next item I have here, I purchased this in Portland and used it religiously for the 5 days that I was there. This is the Aesop facial lotion with sunscreen, SPF 25. Ideally, I'd prefer if the SPF was a tad higher, somewhere between 30 and 45, that range. So it features a pump dispenser. And what I like about this deodorant is that it is thin, it spreads well, it doesn't have my face looking like a ghost. I'm sure it is scented because Aesop scents all of their products, but it's fairly neutral. It's nothing like if you've ever used like Banana Boat or like any of those other sunscreens, it has that sunscreen smell. This does not have that, but you are paying the premium. I forget how much this was, but I remember it being fairly pricey. This is travel size approved, so I do recommend this product. Moving on to books that I picked up. So I picked up two books. These are both from Kinokuniya. This is the ramen book and this is the Wagyu book. So I picked these up because I want to learn more about Wagyu and ramen, two of my favorite dishes to eat. And I want to know more than just, oh, shio, shoyu, miso. Like, I want to know where this broth originated, this style of ramen. I want to know everything, down to the T. I want to know it all. So, and the visuals in both of these books, beautiful. There is Japanese and English. So yeah, just something to sift through when you're lounging around. Same goes for the Wagyu book. I was getting into this book and learning about how Wagyu originated, crossing breeds from different countries. Really cool stuff, in my opinion. So this last book I picked up is called 1,000 Chairs. It is by Charlotte and Peter Feel. It is a Taschen book. So Taschen is a book publisher that started in the 80s. So they started selling comic books, transitioned to pocket-sized art books, and they pride themselves on being conveniently affordable. This hardcover book, it's fairly thick as well, $20. The reason I bought this book is because I like chairs. I like looking at chairs, I like sitting in chairs, and I wanna learn more about chairs in case I go vintage furniture shopping or even at a garage sale. You won't know if you're coming across a steal if you don't know what that chair is. So that's the idea behind this. And it's also another book that is just really easy to sift through and just grow your appreciation for these chairs, these iconic designer chairs, vintage. And then you can kind of see where modern chairs draw their inspiration from. So moving on to a movie recommendation. Before I get started though, I will say that it doesn't have the highest Rotten Tomatoes rating or IMDb rating, but I like the movie because of the aesthetic scenes. There are some very nice iconic chairs in a few of the scenes that are subtly placed, so you really have to look for them. This movie was directed by Matt Asselton. The cast includes Theo James and Emily Ratajkowski, Smoke Show. And it's basically about this art thief, Ivan, who is just trying to leave his like criminal life behind. Without spoiling it, that's all I'll give you. It's a really easy watch. You can kind of leave it in the background and like not have to pay too close attention to it while still enjoying the movie. And yeah, just from the cars to like how they were dressed, the visuals are great. So that's why I'm recommending it. The plot, what can I say? To end off the video, here are some of the songs I've been listening to. Some are old, some are new. So enjoy.
In the driveway, all of y'all won't access what's the code, homie. Why I'm going slower on the highway. Ain't too many living.
living off borrowed time, the clock ticks faster. That'll be the hour they knock the slick blaster. Dick Dastardly and Muttley with sick laughter. A gunfight and they come to cut the mix master. I see.
In another time, in another place.